because they don't. Can't change the world unless we change ourselves. Die from the sicknesses if we don't seek the health. All eyes be my witness when I speak what's felt. Full house on my hands, the cars I was dealt. 3 K's, 2 A's in America. I'm just a black space born out the nebula. And everything I do will say today that's worthwhile. With assurance by your action and your first child, I begin my first nap. Sometimes I speak and I feel like it ain't my words. Like I'm just a vessel channeling inside this universe. I feel my ancestors arrested inside of me. It's like they want me to shoot my chance and change the society. But how do I go about it? Tell me where I start. My destiny rerouted when I chose to follow heart. You told to follow suit, but tell me what they do for you. Except where you down, now you trapped inside the cubicle they built for us. The first step in the change is to take notice. Realize the real games that they tried to show us. 300 plus years of them cold shoulders. Yeah, 300 million of us still got no focus. Sorry, America, but I will not be your soldier. Obama just wasn't enough, I need some more closure. And Donald Trump is not equipped to take this country over. Let's face facts, cause we know what's the real motives. In the land of the free is for the freeloaders. Leave us dead in the street to be the organ donors. They disorganized, my people made the soil owners. Still got the last names of our slave owners.
What up? Welcome back. It's been a minute. Back to the Tea and Cognac session. This is your girl O'Brien, aka OB, aka O, coming to you with episode 11, baby. How y'all doing? How y'all doing? So we come through all the generational curses and whatnot. So I thought, let's go ahead and get into what's about to happen, because, you know, they already switching out the stores and shit, and y'all getting ready to go buy all the hype. Let's get into who the Negroes are and why we are a topic, why we are being hunted, why we are lost as a people. Man, when you get into this shit, this ain't no hocus pocus shit. For those that don't follow the Bible, you can follow history too. Compare what you're missing in your already there knowledge, and then be prepared to be shocked and shook when you find out most of what you done learned all of your life is a bona fide lie. Big orchestrated shit to hide who the children of Israel are. There are 12 tribes, so-called African American would come from Judah. To go further from that, you know, the Bible part of it, you want to remember Japheth, Shem, and Ham, first, second, and third born, and you know, we forget a lot of that backstory. Esau, I remember freaking out when I came across Jew versus Jewish. That would look like Anne Frank. Remember, we learned about Anne Frank in the Holocaust. I'm reading and I'm like, well, okay. If they are Jewish, Kaiser, Turkish, who the fuck is the Jew? Judah. We have gotten so lost in the language. See, they call Hebrew the dead language for a reason. They want to get so far removed from ancient history so we can't connect the dots. So you need to understand your Bible, at least start getting into it. Me personally, I grew up Baptist, and it's been shoved down my throat. So I had to take a long minute. And that was my own personal growth, my own dealing with stuff in my own time before I was ready. You can't let people bully you they're going to just force you to accept what their truth is. And their truth isn't necessarily your truth. You need to find out for yourself. Me, that was my personal issue. So, you know, grew up with very much remembering Bible study and going to Sunday school and whatnot. But I don't remember hitting the 12 tribes too tough. We talked about Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And I remember all the men seemed to always come with power at a young age and had a real issue with following rules and shit. That's what I do remember. And that is what our problem is. Deuteronomy specifically states the curses. We fit the description to a T, the black people. We've gotten so caught up again in bywords. You know, they say Mexican and, you know, Latina. Well, Latina is a language. That's not a lineage. I'm Hispanic. Again, that's not a lineage. That's referencing a part of the Americas, but that's not a lineage. So we get lost in the sauce, but there's 12 bloodlines. And essentially we descend from the 12. Anything outside of that, you either a Gentile or an abomination, but you know, don't get mad at the messenger. Look, we all come from Africa. Africa is the only continent rooted to the earth's core. That's why it's rich in its resources, plentiful, doesn't run out. We just float. The rest of these seven continents, we float. We don't latch to nothing, right? That's why we flood and all kinds. Anyway, so Africa, you know, they've changed the name. At one point it was Pangaea. At one point it was Kemet. It's been called many things, and they've changed the names. And when I say they, I say our predecessors, the people that could do such shit, have changed history, whitewashed history. As a matter of fact, when you change and altogether remove the color from history, we call that whitewashing. And then you cherry pick the good parts, but you don't tell us about the fucked up parts, the raping, the genocide. What has really been done in the name of declaring America, the United States of America? We've allowed, and when I say we, our predecessors, we essentially are an extension of the Roman Empire. Check your history. Look, I can't even waste energy in arguing anymore. The Catholic Church is very much still in power, been pedophiles since the beginning of time and still to this day is, and have not been shut down or shamed or shunned, none of that shit. So it's just, you know, connecting dots. It's a lot of information. And I remember coming into it back in 2015, 16. I mean, I freaked out. And when I couldn't come to family members about it, it was like, it was one of the loneliest times in my life. Because you like, okay, we participating in shit. We ain't got no business. And we don't know who we are as a people. Meanwhile, all kind of shit has told us who we are for decades now. Our music, the movies. I couldn't believe X-Men. X-Men telling me who the Negroes is with all these mutations, and we the mutants, right? We got the superpowers and shit. Basically based off the civil rights movement and Malcolm X. I was blown away. Malcolm X and Martin Luther King. This is supposed to be Xavier and Magneto. Hell yeah. Got a whole new respect for some shit, you know? Avatar was about the colonizers taking over an African tribe. The Matrix, the children of Zion and shit. It's like Earth, Wind, and Fire was even telling us, you know? Erykah Badu, Nas. Who are the Negroes? It's not hard to find out if you really want to know. And, Deuteronomy, like I said, the Exodus and Revelations is to the T right about now. So much shit going on. You don't know which end is up. Antichrist, all kind of shit going on. And not a whole lot of, I don't know, reliable sources, because you got a lot of celebrities pushing an agenda that's not so much for your benefit. Just because it's popular, just because everybody else doing it, does not mean you're supposed to be doing it too. So here we are. So anyway, on Columbus Day, I just wanted to do a quick little reference for your education on this so-called Murders Day. This fool is nothing to be celebrated. But again, we got more murderers on our printed money and all kind of shit. Y'all celebrate some fucked up mother foes. Sorry. You want to get into it? Start with the Book of Negroes. Then there's another series, Hebrews to Negroes. Amendment 13 was on Netflix for a long minute. I think it's still there. Hidden Color series, all of them. I think is there six of them now? All of them. I definitely recommend the first three for sure. But once you get started, you can't stop type shit. For as far as your professors and whatnot, Dr. Jokamon and Dr. John Henry Clark is who I kind of started with a couple of years back. Of course, Dr. Francis Wilson and, you know, Marcus Garvey and Malcolm X, all of those. I don't too much thrive on Martin Luther King, just because that was one of their puppets. I'm sorry. The dirt that man did, but we don't talk about, you know, not being disrespectful, but we don't know a lot of stuff. And as we go into this next election, they shaming you for not wanting to vote. Look, scripture say choosing the lesser of the evil is still sin. So we see we got some jacked up stuff going on in our politics. Our system is damn broken. But instead of sitting down and collectively saying, no, not until we fix our system, we're going to go ahead and participate in some crazy shit. I'm sorry, that's the definition of crazy. Doing the same shit and expecting a different result. Your electoral college is designed to put the president in its seat, not the majority vote. So as you try to shun and tell me my ancestor died for this, No, they did not die for this fuckery here. The shenanigans that's going on in the news and how innocent people are being shot and killed in their own home. And the officers are just being let go. But you telling me I'm supposed to be participating in your broken system? No. I cannot teach my son the lie. And I'm sorry, American tradition is a lie. And what you are witnessing right now in 2020 is the lie crumbling. We claim American, you know, so our pride and whatever. We have no heritage. America has no heritage. It's built on murder, genocide, and thievery. Plain. You've changed the names of people by words. We have our name has changed so many damn times in history. Who are we? Who are you really hiding? Who do you have in captivity still? We are not free people. So we think we are. Hey. So yeah, that's it. Get into who are the Negroes. You really want to question African American? That's not our name. It's important on the names as you in your faith. If you call on Jesus, I want to let you know if you don't already, because some know and don't care. But if you don't know, the letter J is only 600 years or less old. So that means his name ain't Jesus. And the other names we like to call on are titles. So you want to be careful in what you getting caught up in. Jesus, God, Jesus Christ. These are titles and oftentimes deities. So when we say amen, that's a deity. That's one of them out of Ra, out of, ancient Egypt. You didn't know that. ain't know it either. Scared the shit out of me. So anyway, it's just, we need to know we come from some serious shit. Royalty. And as we are watching just some of the most murderous shit go on in America, 2020, Columbus Day, they really have a national holiday for this murderer. And it's not okay. Just because you look different from the next person of color, you are not supposed to hate them. It is colorism we suffer from in America. We are messed up mentally. And we have a lot of post-traumatic stress from the shit that has happened. Mississippi and other southern slave states. We have history that is, it is heartbreaking to find out what has really been done in the dark. And they capes and shit are being snatched off. But the cowards are exposed. Get started, people. Your faith, you claiming religion and faith and God, you better be careful on who you really claiming. And I will assure you, the Bible is definitely a history book. It is missing 14 books, the Apocrypha. Those are books alone. Tell you who the black people are and what happened and why we've been scattered. Never lost, we were scattered. The book of Enoch is a mug. From what I've read of it, is woo-wee. It's just, you either want to know or you don't. And scripture says only a third gonna wake up. So are you part of the third, or are you the sheep that's gonna go on off the cliff with everybody else? That's cool. Don't be shunning me and shit, because I done peeped it, and I'm not passing this down to sir. We getting ready to go into this holiday season, and we going to talk about that shit next episode. But I wanted y'all to get a little acquainted with some of these words and shit, bywords, and what your lineage is. I want to encourage you to go to my page, The Melanin Initiative. I try to do a lot of factual, whatever, history, memes and whatnot. So you just peep some of this. If you don't know how to spell some of this shit, I had to Google myself and get started with just on the anyway, it's the, I'm sorry, that was a whole call coming through and it scared the shit out of me because I'm okay. Anyway, so that's episode 11. History lesson, just a little bit of a sprinkle kind of everywhere. I touched some of everything, but walk away knowing 12 tribes of Israel, Jew versus Jewish, and Frank, who is that? The synagogue of Satan is currently who's claiming to be the chosen people. And what you're witnessing is the new world order coming to full light. So it's, you know, it's definitely prophecy being fulfilled. If like I said, you're into the Bible and whatnot, 1619 to 2019 was 400 years. So this year we would see pretty much the gates of hell busting open because this has already been written. And you can believe it or not, but something is definitely happening. So, yeah, buckle up, buttercup. It's just going to get better. I feel like this year ain't done. This year, 2020, going to make sure it go out with a motherfucking boom. So stay prayed up and check on your peoples. Fuck with those that fuck with you and keep it pushing. It is what it is. I believe this is not built for the faint of heart. You will have to be tough. And suck some shit up and buckle down. I'm telling myself the same stuff. So anyway, check me out on Facebook. The Jill of Most Trades, OSD, The Melanin Initiative. And I will be back soon with another one. Y'all take care out there. Peace.